Hello moneymakers, let's see today's top 5 market updates. China warns it will retaliate on moves over Hong Kong by the U.S. China said on Monday U.S. attempts to harm Chinese interests will be met with firm countermeasures. They also criticize a U.S. decision to begin ending special treatment for Hong Kong, as well as actions against Chinese students and companies. China's parliament last week voted to move forward with imposing national security legislation on Hong Kong. U.S. President Donald Trump said on Friday was a tragedy for the people of the city and which violated China's promise to protect its autonomy. Trump ordered his administration to begin the process of eliminating special U.S. treatment for Hong Kong to punish China, ranging from extradition treatment to export controls. Oil prices edge up ahead of upcoming OPEC Plus meeting. Oil prices were little changed on Monday, with the Organization of the Petroleum Exporting Countries, OPEC, considering meeting as soon as this week to discuss whether to extend record production cuts beyond end June. Brent crude was unchanged at $37.84 a barrel in the first day of trading in the contract, with August as the front month. WTI crude futures for July delivery were at $35.53 a barrel, up 4 cents. The price falls come after front month Brent and WTI prices posted their strongest monthly gains in years in May, with demand expected to recover as more nations emerge from coronavirus lockdowns. China halts few U.S. agri purchases due to Hong Kong tensions. China has ordered major state-run firms to pause some purchases of farm goods from the United States, including soybeans, as Beijing evaluates tensions with Washington over Hong Kong. Chinese buyers have also canceled an unspecified number of U.S. pork orders, according to the report. Emirates president states could take 4 years to rebuild the network. Emirates President Tim Clark said on Monday it could take the airline 4 years to rebuild its network that has been decimated by the coronavirus pandemic. Probably by the year 2022-23, 2023-24 they will see things coming back to some degree of normality, and Emirates will be operating its network as it was, and hopefully as successfully as it was. The Dubai-based airline was flying to 157 destinations in 83 countries before it grounded passenger flights in March and has since operated limited services. Japan's April tax revenues see biggest monthly drop in over 10 years. Japan's tax revenue dropped 29.4% in April compared with a year earlier. The Finance Ministry data showed on Monday, posting its biggest monthly year-on-year decline since August 2009. The payment deadline was pushed back due to COVID-19. Analysts expect further slides over a protracted period as the coronavirus outbreak deals a heavy blow to the economy. They said this raised the prospect of further debt issuance to make up the income gap as the government boosts spending in Japan, which has the heaviest public debt burden among major economies, at more than twice its $5 trillion economy. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for regular updates, only at Capital Street FX. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for regular updates, only at Capital Street FX.